In the heart of Dunedin lies the emblem of local rugby madness, Forsyth Bar Stadium, New Zealand's biggest glasshouse and home of the mighty Highlanders.
This is where our Tiger rugby offices are.
And it's now home to Highlanders legend Seilala Mapusua, 3 days a week to be exact, or so he says.
Most days I'm here, but then afternoons and evenings, it's just time. I said most days.
After a decade spent playing professionally offshore, he's back where it all began, this time behind the scenes guiding young players in the region.
Right, so don't worry about what's outside you.
I think the biggest thing is seeing the development in players and coaches and people in general. Pretty blessed to spend as much time in the game as I have, and you know, this is a great way for me to give it back.
It's been 18 years since Seilala first set foot in the Deep South, fresh out of Wesley College to play for Otago in the 2000 provincial season.
I always did enjoy watching Otago play, especially in the 90s. You know, they were adventurous, they were free-flowing and quite innovative, and then to actually get to play for them was pretty special.
Seilala Mapusua turning opportunism into optimism.
Over the next 6 years, Seilala played 74 games for Otago and 50 games for the Highlanders before pledging his allegiance to Samoa, despite knocking on the door of an All Black selection.
I'm not going to lie, it would have been great to be an All Black, you know? I don't know if you've heard of them, they're the two guys there at the time. One was called named Tana Umanga and the other was called Ma'anonu. Yeah, you may have heard of them.
One of his biggest highlights in the blue jersey, Manu Samoa's shock win over the Wallabies in 2011, sending Samoan fans into a frenzy ahead of the World Cup later that year.
Picked this team with all young guys coming through. We looked at our team and we had seasoned international players. We had guys playing professionally all around the world. I think it was a really fair reflection of how the game panned out.
Now, after 10 years playing in Japan and Europe, Seilala continues his rugby passion back home in Dunedin, with his biggest supporters in tow who admit there's no place like home.
Oh, it's wonderful. Now that we're all home and settled, it's taken a while. It's definitely taken a while to settle back into life in New Zealand, but it's great.
Finally to be home, somewhere we can stay. All my friends are here as well, so it's good to be back.
Get up! Push that, Chucky! Seilala's latest role as coach development officer for the ORU gives him the often challenging task of growing the game in the region. And then there's the role as board member for Pacific Rugby Players, a body which looks after the welfare of players on and off the field. That's why he often takes a special interest in Pacific players who head to the Deep South.
When they're down there, I really feel like I can influence them and help them through this part of the journey and help them not just develop them as rugby players, but develop them as people.